As a society, we're facing significant challenges and we cannot afford building the same way we do now. There's a large opportunity looking at existing building services and how inflexible they are for how we work in our current environment. I'm Tim Schork, Associate Professor in the School of Architecture at the University of Technology, Sydney. My passion is to change our building industry in order to have a more sustainable future.
At BVN, we've been doing workplace design for 20 years, and really what we wanted to find are research partners who, one, can help us advance a solution to an existing problem, but also partners who can bring sort of great intellectual rigour and equally be extremely collaborative. One of the things that we felt just hadn't really been tackled particularly well was how we deliver air to existing office buildings. So Systems Reef 2 is really about 3D printing air.
This has never been done before. We developed a robotic 3D printing process in which the robot can strategically place holes or pores within the 3D print. And we also developed a novel 3D printing process where the robot, instead of just laying things in flat, the robot can use its ability to move freely in space to create branching objects in 3D space.
The construction industry in Australia is one of the least digitised globally. We have one of the highest levels of waste out of OECD countries, and it's really important to us that, you know, as architects, that we're making a more positive contribution to that story, and we're starting to influence the industry to change.
What I'm really excited about is that we're able to not only design the world's first robotic 3D printed air diffusion system, but we're also able to reduce the embedded carbon within the system by 89% compared to an existing solution. Only by working closely together were we able to design and fabricate this unique system.
Coming at the problem from multiple angles is really important. University of Technology in particular, they can come at it from a slightly more academic standpoint. We're really good at identifying maybe where some of these wicked problems lie within the world, and we're doing that because we're seeing it so regularly in the work that we're doing. And I think we're constantly learning from each other, and we're kind of lifting each other's contribution through shared knowledge and shared collaboration.
What was really great about the project, we both share the same values. We are both passionate about the environment. We both want to change the industry.
I'm really proud of what we've been able to do. First of all, it's great that you can collaborate with a group of like-minded people and have a fantastic journey in that process. And then the other thing is, we think we've created something that hasn't been done in the world before. And there is really a lot to be gained from these kinds of collaborations. And actually, I can't stress enough how important it is that industry and academia continue to work together, and that we both bring, you know, our strengths into these relationships.